Ladies and gentlemen, come gather around, come gather around, come gather around. Today, we're going to look at your engine's breathing. Not the intake system, not the exhaust system, but the crankcase system. Oh yeah, the positive crankcase ventilation system, one of the most neglected parts of your car and mine. We're going to take a look at it and maybe do some servicing. Let's go!
So what is the PCV system, you're asking? Well, I'm glad you asked. If we go inside the engine, we have combustion. And no seals are perfect inside the motor. And some of that combustion is put to work for us and moves the piston and rotates the crankshaft and you do a big hazer in front of your house. Some of it leaks past the rings, which are imperfect seals. They get into the crankcase of the engine block and then puke out into atmosphere. So what we're going to do to help protect the atmosphere is we're going to bring in some fresh air into one side of the motor, have it pick up all the disgusting schmoo that leaks past everything, and we're going to suck it into the intake manifold and burn it so we can protect Mother Nature. So let's look at this in action. Well, that's maybe a bit too close up. If you take your oil fill cap off while the engine's running and a whole bunch of smoke comes out, you have a lot of stuff blowing past the rings. That's nasty. You can see if the system's working by putting a piece of paper over top of the oil fill. It should be sucking air in because you've opened up the system and now it's not getting air from the filter. It's sucking in through the oil fill cap. And this, it's a little hard to see, but it is physically fluttering and sucking the paper into the oil fill opening. Don't do this if your engine has a timing chain nearby. You're going to wear a lot of your motor oil. Let's zoom out a bit because that's a little bit too close. I don't actually run 5W20, I run 10W30 diesel oil, because I think it's better that way. Come on, zoom out. Zoom out! No, out. Who's operating this thing? Another thing you can do, not easy in this case, is I can disconnect the PCV valve itself, stick my thumb over the end, and it should change the idle speed. That may or may not happen, because the computer might try to adjust the idle speed for you, but it should affect the idle to a certain extent.
So the pistons out of your engine have rings on them, usually two compression rings. And the gap that is in between here has to be there or you'll never get these rings on the pistons. And the space is actually a specific gap that it's supposed to be. So that when you're pulling the steepest of hills, hauling the largest of a payload with your heaviest of friends, and there's so much heat inside here, these rings don't overheat, expand, and then butt together. If they butt together, you break the piston. So the gap is actually kind of important. Sadly, these rings sliding on the cylinders are a sliding kind of friction. There's lots of oil in the bottom of the engine splashing all over the place, so the bottom of the cylinder really doesn't wear very much. Up here, the compression ring, and oil scraper ring, these try to keep all the oil out of the combustion chamber. So the fire can happen here, oil's down there. Some oil is going to get up here, but it'll probably get washed off by gasoline and burnt by combustion. So eventually, the cylinder may wear out bigger and bigger and bigger because these rings are scraping the iron away. And we end up with a slightly larger cylinder at the top. Plus, part of the ring material gets scraped away and these gaps get bigger and bigger and bigger. Over time, oil can get into the combustion chamber and combustion gases can work its way down into the crankcase. Combustion gases getting into the crankcase are a problem. Think of it as exhaust, actually, which is kind of what it is, actually getting into the oil. You don't want to cover your oil with exhaust and have that start to corrode and eat out the bearings and destroy the engine prematurely. This is the original engine and transmission out of my 1961 Chevy Apache pickup. Check the link up here if you want to see what I did with that vehicle. In these days, 1961, this is how we dealt with the fumes coming out of the crankcase. It's just a pipe coming up here and a tube that would puke it all onto the ground. Anything that got past the rings came out that tube and just puked onto the ground. That's how we took care of it because the environment hadn't been invented yet. More modern engines like Pinky over here deal with it in a more eco-friendly way. There's going to be some kind of connection in one side of the motor. This gets sucked up to the intake manifold somewhere, maybe there, but I'm not really sure because this has been taken apart a while ago. But let's say this thing goes right into the intake manifold, so when the engine is on the intake stroke and sucks air and fuel in, it'll suck in all the nasties that are inside the crankcase. Whatever got past the rings is going to get sucked through here into the intake system, and then we'll burn it, which is better than sending it off to Mother Nature. In order for the fumes to get out, we have to let fresh air in. So from the air filter, fresh air will go into this guy, go into this side of the engine, and as it gets drawn through on the intake stroke from the engine into here, into the intake manifold. So we can get all the junk that's inside our block into there. If you're buying a used vehicle and there's a whole bunch of oil in here or wherever that hose goes, the filter is saturated with oil, you know there is so much combustion gas that's going past the rings, blowing past the rings, we call it blow-by. There's so much going past the rings that we're kind of overloading the system. And some of that nastiness will come into here, but some of it may actually end up coming back into here and blowing into the air filter. So a good idea that your vehicle is kind of tired, when you open up that air filter connection, if it's this thing is just caking oil all over the place, those rings are likely shot. This valve is the positive crankcase ventilation valve. It ventilates the crankcase. This old Chevy, filtered air goes into here, and it's supposed to go into here down in the valve cover, but that piece is missing, so this has been capped off. The PCV valve should be in the other valve cover, and it's right back there. This guy, I don't know if you can see that, so that guy plugs right into the valve cover and then goes right into the intake manifold. So fresh air, filtered fresh air is drawn into that valve cover through the hose that's missing. And then the disgusting stank gets sucked out through that hose into the intake system and burnt. One of the reasons we got this vehicle so affordably is the previous owner didn't pay attention to the oil level and it ran out of oil and grenaded the motor. Had the owner, and should you own a vehicle, check the oil. See if it's consuming oil faster than you'd expect, or a lot more frequently you need to top it up. And then take it to a shop, tell them what's going on. Often, not always, but often, it's the crankcase ventilation system. And had they checked, they would have noticed that the little hose that goes from here to the intake manifold of the system was completely caked, plugged full of carbon, and the engine didn't like that. So this one, different motor. My son and I put this motor in a couple years ago. We cleaned this so we can make it go a little bit longer. Here's how. So I neglected to buy one, but I can probably keep this going a little bit longer. What I did was I got some heavy duty oven cleaner, put it in a tin can inside this ultrasonic cleaner, and ultrasonically cleaned all of this. And there's like, you can see oven cleaner and all the schmoo inside there. Oven cleaner dissolves carbon. This is covered with carbon, or was. Wear safety protection because you are a carbon-based life form. And it took about 5 or 10 minutes of ultrasonically shaking this in oven cleaner, and it looks like it's good to go. So we're going to run it. So the PCV valve on this Honda Civic is in a wonderful place of no thank you. It's... if I can even get you in there. All right, shock tower, air conditioning fitting, brake master cylinder. Can you see that threaded hole down there? I'll circle it for you. That's where the PCV valve comes. I'll just move back here so you can kind of get an idea of where you need to get your hands into. That's a whole lot of no fun, unless you got small hands. The PCV valve looks like this. It has a spring-loaded plug on the end, which kind of, it's a metered orifice. This part goes to the intake manifold and it sucks all the schmoo that got past the rings into the intake over here. If the crankcase is full of pressure, this is gonna blow past there. If there's a backfire in the intake system, it seals that thing off so you don't ignite everything down below. It comes with a washer. On this car, I used a 17 millimeter deep socket because it's got to fit over top of this on a stubby ratchet because that's what got in there. Whether you're putting a new one in or cleaning the old one, and it's not a bad thing to, as a service, just to clean the one you have. I'm going to put some Never Sees on here because I'm always mindful I might be the next guy going in. So I'm doing that. I know PCV valves are cheap, but just cleaning it is preventative maintenance, and that's pretty free. Here on the firewall side of things. Let's see if I can find my hands. There's my ratchet. That's about it. I don't know if I can get a little more greedy with tightening it. They don't exactly come off. There we go. And that's where you are, deep in the bowels of the system. It's like an exhaust port, about the size of a womp rat.
In this case, we're on my daily driver Hyundai Accent 2010. I may have a playlist here where I show you installing lowering springs, fabricating rear sway bars, widening a set of steel wheels, and all that joyous goodness. Hyundai's pretty cool. They put this right on the top, right in the valve cover, which is very kind of them. Always compare to make sure your new parts are, in fact, the same as the old parts. In this case, I didn't use Neverseize. I used a little bit of thread sealer, just because it seemed to only seal by the threads. So I want to make sure it does. No air leaks or vacuum leaks. And the cover goes back on, make it all nice and pretty. And again, look, Neverseize. I love Neverseize, man. Interesting the debate between whether you should use copper or nickel-based Neverseize.
On this car, the PCV system's been deleted. You don't want to do that. Here's why. So originally, on this Corolla GTS engine, there was a hose that went from here to the intake air stream ahead of the throttle body. There was no way for fresh air to get in the crankcase, so Toyota had this run kind of on a vacuum. When air is being drawn into the motor, stuff would get drawn out of here. Anything that got past the rings would just get sent into the intake system. When I switched this to independent throttle bodies, I don't have a way of hooking up the crankcase vapor to the incoming airstream easily. Instead of drawing the fumes out, I just have them puke out to Mother Nature with a filter. And this has actually, this is a problem. I recently cleaned the fuel injectors on here, so I hosed this whole thing down, but the whole engine has had a nasty coating of motor oil and blow-by that's been coming out of that filter and going everywhere. I'm going to try and pipe this into the intake system just so that I can draw something out of here in a vacuum, hopefully to save my motor oil, but also to stop this thing from going everywhere. The other part to this is I don't drive this car gently at all, and the engine's getting a little tired. It's like 16 years old since I freshened it up, and there's a bit of blow-by and the rings are getting a little bit tired and it uses a bit of oil. But the pressure that builds up in the crankcase, if it can't get out of that little tiny filter, it's going to try to find its way out of other places. And so it creates oil leaks as the pressure can't find somewhere to go. And the motor oil in this goes black really fast because it's just soaking up all the carbon that's showing up from the rings. And I need to change the oil on a frequent basis here. Like about every 1,000 kilometers, maybe less, I need to change it because it's looking gross. So we took a look at the positive crankcase ventilation system, the importance of it with respect to the environment, the importance of it with respect to our engine's longevity. We looked at testing it, servicing it, cleaning it if you're really cheap, replacing it, the importance of not deleting it, and now you too can maintain your engine in an area that most of us tend to neglect. It's not hard to do, it's not expensive, and it could pay dividends if it doesn't destroy your motor. So if it saves a motor, it's worth it. In the meantime, I gotta figure out how to get the PCV working on this engine, because that was a mistake. As always, take care. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you again.